We lock our doors, check them twice, install cameras, build fences, all for security. So why don't we secure our accounts with the same vigor? Hello viewers, my name is Alana, and I'm about to give you some super helpful tech tips, sponsored by Digi. Security is something that's constantly on everyone's mind. It's one of the most basic human needs. Safety and peace of mind are invaluable, and for good reason. That's why sometimes people can be a little skeptical of the internet, that seemingly lawless wild web. We often have very precious information on our accounts about our finances, our personal lives, and some pretty embarrassing pictures from high school. Although I've talked before about how to be sure that your password is airtight and uncrackable, a little extra layer of security couldn't hurt. Two-factor authentication, also known as two-step verification, is a method that most sites allow you to opt into. It's like having two locks on your door. When you enable two-step verification, you can enter your password like normal as the first step. The second step comes in when the site that you are logging onto sends a randomized code to your phone via SMS or to your email. Once you receive this code, you enter it to complete your login process. This method of logging in takes a little more time, but it's much more secure. Even if someone has guessed your password, they won't be able to access your account unless they have that second code, which usually expires if it's not used quickly enough. The code also changes every single time you log in to ensure that your data stays protected. Your email server and social media websites most likely have this option. Try checking your account settings and looking under a privacy tab to see if this method of login is available for you. Next up, one of my personal favorite things about technology is how much more easily accessible it makes everything. In this world, not everyone has the same abilities, but whether you or your loved one has a visibility, mobility, or hearing impairment, your phone has great features that can help you out. For instance, if you know your mom can never read her text messages or Facebook posts without straining her eyes, search for accessibility in her phone settings. Both Android and Apple have options to make font sizes larger. You can also change your phone's contrast settings to help with eye strain, enable speech so words can be read aloud by a voice, and a variety of other visibility assisting functions. If you know someone who can't hear when they get a notification, turn on LED flash so that your phone's flashlight can give them a visible cue that someone is calling or texting or even like their latest Instagram post. You can even hook up your phone to a hearing aid via Bluetooth if your hearing device has that option. Life in 2019 means that everyone should be able to enjoy all the fantastic uses technology has to offer. Well, we've come to the end of another segment of Tech Tips. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Thank you.